Now, in order to give it a proper shape, to simplify this one, we define x equal, this is, I have supposed f of x here, this x, small x is basically, we are defining R over A, then I can write this equation is f of x is equal to minus 1 and then minus 2 here and then start over here. As this is A over R, so it will come out to be 1 over x minus, then we have 1 plus A over R, so it is again 1 over x, then e to the power R over A, so this is minus 2x. And further, let's complete here this one, and then plus 1 plus R over A, so 1 plus x, and e to the power minus x, because minus R over A, then the this term, the denominator term will be equal to 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus R over A, so this is 1 plus x plus 1 over 3 x squared and e to the power minus x, and plus this term will come out to be 2 over x, because A over R, so 1 over x, so 2 over x. Now we will have to simplify this thing, and its simplification is not the difficult. We are having 1 over x here, this term will multiply with this, similarly this will multiply, we will multiply this term, and there is a step-by-step explanation, and I have done this explanation in the lecture notes, and you can follow the lecture notes for the simplification. And finally, what we will have, we will have f of x equal, the final form of f of x is equal to minus 1 plus 2 over x minus 1 plus 2 over x, and then we have 1 minus 2 over 3x, 1 minus 2 over 3x e to the power minus x, and plus 1 plus x e to the power minus 2x here. Here is 2 minus 2x, and this is divided by 1 plus x plus 1 over 3 x squared and e to the power minus x. So this is the final form that we are having. We are having very few steps simplification, and then we get this one. Now understand this one first. What is f of x? F of x is basically the normalized number, because f of x is equal to the e total divided by e1. So it is in the units of this one. So we can plot this f of x with respect to x. Now what is x basically? What was R? R was the separation between the two protons, and it has been normalized with a Bohr radius. So it is also dimensionless. This x is dimensionless. So we can plot f of x with x, and I have means I have written this equation in Python, and I have plotted f of x with x, and the plot is also in the lecture notes, and you can see the different values there. Although the graph in the book, which is the figure 7.7, you have in the Griffith's book, that one is a very zoom plot. What I have plotted is a complete range, but we have the same conclusion that bonding is occurring here. And this is, if I do plot this one, so we have this is we are plotting f of x against here is basically x, f of x and x here. Now their values, this one is starting from 0 to 6. From 0 here, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 here. So what does it mean? It means 1 Bohr radius, 2 Bohr radius, 3, 4, and so on. Because it is divided, x is divided by here, r over a. So when x is equal to 1, then it means that r is equal to 1 Bohr radius. When x is equal to 2, then it means r equal to 2 Bohr radius, and so on. And this one, the f of x, the value starts from 0 here, and then it gradually decreases, and this value is minus 1.2. This value is 1.2 minus. So it starts from 0 and then 0.2, and steps of 0.2, I have the plots I have reproduced in the notes, and here we have 0.6 and so on. So the plot is something like this, means if this value is minus 1, this value like here, minus 1.0 here, then the, and I extend this one, so we have something like this. The plot comes in here, and then it slightly goes here and then goes like this. So this portion that we are having here, the bonding, when it becomes less than minus 1, we are having the bonding, and the bonding nature is covalent in nature, because the electron is shared between the two protons, and here the energy comes below a neutral hydrogen atom plus a proton with that system. And there are some experimental values, although my figure scale wise might not be that accurate, but in the lecture notes you will find the exact plot of Python. And here we have the actual value of this, that it's a covalent bond with the electron shared equally by the two protons. The equilibrium separation of proton is about 2.4 Bohr radius. So here something around me like 2.5, so 4 here. The scale might not be that accurate, but we are having this thing is equal to 2.4 Bohr radius, 2.4 and Bohr radius A, and which is equivalent to 1.3 angstrom here, while the experimental value is 1.06 angstrom. So very close to that one, because this is almost 1.1 angstrom, and the one that we calculated is 1.3 angstrom, and the binding energy is 1.8 electron volt. Like here it goes 1.8 electron volt, so we have the 1.8 electron volt, while the experimental one is 2.8 electron volt. So in all this topic you can find in the lecture notes, or the I have reproduced the code as well of Python, which you can copy and you can run in Python, and it will give you the required plot. So what we conclude here, that we considered a system, we varied the distances, and we came to know that when an electron comes in between two protons, and the two protons are having equal chance to interact with this one, then we got a point where the energy becomes less than that of the neutral hydrogen atom and a proton with it. When it goes below that one, then it means bonding has occurred. So this is quite amazing here. And is we have 1.8 electron volt, and then here the experimental one is 2.8 electron volt, and that's the reason the variational principle is always overestimates the ground state energy. So we have utilized the variational principle to calculate that energy, that when bonding will occur, what energy it will have. So far, this was a comparatively very lengthy topic. Although the conclusion is very simple, but there was a lot of mathematics involved in this one, and I have tried to go briefly over it while doing all the steps inside the lecture notes. So if you want to do the steps, practice the steps, then you can have the support from the lecture notes. So with this, this topic ends, and this chapter ends as well.